This is an event that's organized by the Fish and Wildlife Service and a bunch of different agencies like the Fish and Wildlife Service and Department of Natural Resources come together to try to assess the status of the federally endangered Higgins eye mussel. And so our main objective today was to locate as many of the Higgins eye mussels as we can, clean the invasive zebra mussels off those mussels, and then stockpile them so that if biologists are going to do a reintroduction or captive breeding program, they'll know where they can get a good supply of the endangered creatures.
Many people don't know this, but North America, and especially the Mississippi River watershed, is like the hot spot for freshwater mussel diversity around the world. There are estimates of, like, I think 60 species of freshwater mussels in North America, but now that's declined significantly. This is really, really valuable biodiversity that's being lost due to habitat destruction and invasive species. Zebra mussels were introduced from Asia, I believe, in like the 1980s, and they have since just taken over all the river systems in the Midwest and East. They'll colonize any hard surface, and so that includes native mussel shells, and essentially just crowd out these mussels and make it impossible for them to feed or breathe or anything like that. So we're doing our little part to help combat that.
It's easy to walk along the river and not know much about what lives there, but you start to get an appreciation for the diverse community that's out there when you pick them up and hold them in your hands. But I think even more broadly than that, it's one thing to sit in a classroom and talk about mussels and talk about the role that they play in an ecosystem. It really makes a much bigger difference in the way you think about nature when you get out in it and can actually hold some of it and work with it. Most folks, I would say, in an undergraduate education aren't able to do any work with endangered species at all, but here we're able to get out and actually touch them and hold them and identify them and do something that really contributes to their survival, and I think that's a pretty special thing to be able to do.